Yes, my people. Una, good afternoon, good morning, good evening, depending on the location and for the connect with us, talking as they be. We thank Baba God for what he do for our life, because not only when they put road for where not they, not only when they talk, but when they reach. Different truth, you know, this boyfriend. Community where good people for keep quiet, and Baba will become general overseer. What is not good is bad. So we carry waka come out this afternoon. You know, so we waka for everywhere. You see, we know say time dolly for us to give our people the right information about governance in Edo. Remember, if we not get the right information, negative propaganda will continue to fly. So our own mission at Osea will fit to change the negative narrative about governance in Edo. So this afternoon, by the grace of God, we carry waka come government house. You know, say too many road day. We need to break all the protocol to say we must enter government house. We hear so many things. Now we come carry waka come the office of the SA on media, Mr. Kuzo Osagi. Make it come to command for so many things where we the year because we need to waka. Then we carry waka come the office this afternoon. Baga, good afternoon, sir.
My brother, I thank you very much. We see all the work we need to do. Well done.
Thank you very much, sir. You do well. Those people want to hear from you again. They want to know your name again.
My name is Kuzo Osagi. I'm the special advisor to Governor Obaseki on media projects.
Wow. Magana, well done.
Thank you.
We will see the work we want to do. Across the city, we will see different projects. Now I begin to ask questions. Who they do this thing? Who they do this thing? You know, my own. I'm going to carry a camera. I say, I don't agree. I must make sure say, people see what Oga they do. So, Ogasa, no vessel. I guess so many questions I want to ask you today.
No problem.
The first question when I want to ask you, sir, concerning this Osium Online, how is it a position to take benefit us directly or indirectly for a do? Because at the system, the power line, they really do street light, the work out, and so many areas still be where they need this light. So, I beg our people want to hear from you, sir.
Okay, well, the Osiomo Power, now, I think one of the most strategic moves when this Governor Godwin Noregase Obaseki, when he make, once, when he come for first term. Well, you see, our governor is a strategic thinker.
Yes.
Our governor not the average, not the average leader. Far above average, very strategic thinker.
Mm.
This crisis went there for diesel matter today.
Yes. Hey,
as I'm talking to you now, diesel is not less than 820 naira anywhere. 820 per liter. This governor, imagine like 6 years ago, don't already see him.
Okay.
This diesel, what, get accident for front. So how can we prepare ourselves for that kind of crisis? Now this governor begin to calculate. He said, look, this depending entirely on BDC. No, we'll cut out. Because these BDC people, the way that they do their business, I'm not sure say it will help ordinary people. So this government begin to think. So he now started a conversation with private investors.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this governor now expert in dealing with private investors.
Yes,
because he's an investment banker by training. Come again, talk to them. Eventually secured an agreement, what we call a power purchase agreement with a private investor called Osiomo Power. And the Edo State government brought some, you know, incentives to that investment by way of land, by way of all the regulatory requirements, and then by way of guaranteeing all the power, procurement of all the power that is going to be produced by the Osiomo Power, that helped to mobilize the resources to invest in the power plant. Then a massive power plant was built. As of today, that power plant, the capacity is heading to 100 megawatts.
100 megawatts.
As we talk right now. So that power now, start from Olugbo side, they can begin wheel them out of Olugbo with lines.
Okay.
So all the way to Ring Road, from Ring Road, and now they can begin spread down to different parts of the town. As they come from Sapele Road, come straight to Ring Road, this Ring Road can begin move to Ubowo, through Akwakwaba side, move to what they call them, Uba Hill,
okay.
Move to Kenwa Road, move to Airport Road, just begin and you be like a hub and spoke,
okay.
No hub of bicycle.
Yes.
All those spoke won't connect to that.
Begin to spread, come off
like that. So as we talk now, this life when you see so, this life when inside this my office.
Yes.
I'll see more power.
Wow.
If you go Sapele Road now, you see all the government
offices
there
now
power. But you see, government also they test the waters on how to make sure say even ordinary people they get this power.
Now, go so.
Yeah, because large private enterprises now don't they begin to hook up
okay.
to some of power. As when you talk to Hallmark,
okay.
that big supermarket for Sapele,
you don't connect.
Get one place where they do children they play for Pupan Junction.
Rain.
You don't get some of power.
Wow.
I don't know whether Market Square, let's say Market Square said don't get. I'm not so sure about Market Square. Then some churches said don't begin make requests.
Churches don't
yes.
Okay.
So a Heritage Assembly is connected to some of power as we talk. Central Baptist Church is connected. You wow. follow me, so?
Yeah, they follow
me. So we are now beginning to test the waters and say, okay, how can this be sent to people to that like, won't just be government? So ordinary people are beginning to also tap into the same of power and getting connected. Airport, I hear, says, don't be connected. You know,
they connect and they go airport now.
Yes. Wow. Our airport here now.
Okay.
You know, with the board, they don't go that side now. You know, so a lot of organizations are being connected. EBS has been approved for connection. Nigeria wow. Union of Journalists, NUJ, Edo Secretariat. It's connected as many talk. So if you go in UJ right now, go look up your street light there. And some power you see from there.
Wow.
So the street lights when you see from beginning in the night, now show more power. Go look Secretariat building, you see and see you'll be like in a Canary Wharf for London. Now you did. Now some more power and be all the zone you see. So why I talk say this government are one of the most strategic thinkers for Nigeria? Because imagine say that time people they complain our detractors. They complain, no light, no street light. That time the government was planning how to ensure that the power that is used to generate the street light is affordable and sustainable.
Okay.
So assuming it's in a diesel they use the power of street light.
Yeah,
well for see money, 829 they buy 1 liter to the power street light for the heart of it. So that's how strategic this government is. That's how intelligent this governor is. You are looking for intelligent governor, you have one in Edo. He's an extremely intelligent man,
wow.
He's an extremely strategic man, and he's an extremely somebody when you get people feeling.
Human feeling.
Yes.
Warm the eat food for
better. Person when you get human feeling, you will think of human being, will say, how can I make life easier for these people? So now the kind governor won't get. And then people have always asked us, well now they see money, when I tell they do all these things. He's also a very, very, a prudent.
Not a spender anyhow.
He's not a reckless spender. Wow. And he's not a corrupt governor. He's a very, very transparent governor. Wow. That's how the money today comes. So, because if anything, the money we would get for those states has reduced from what it used to be before.
Yes.
But we have done more than governments did in the past. Why? Because of prudence in spending and because of, reducing to the barest minimum. Corruption and other malpractice.
Thank you very much, sir. I know say our people, when are they gather on a question? Oga Cruz will be here, when are they gather on a question? Another question, one quick answer. What about residential home? I know say people now they ask, like the ring road, the gap, baba, what about we, the resident? So how much can one also reach them?
Now they explain just now. See, okay. Don't come off from government now.
Okay.
You don't need text them with supermarkets.
Okay.
The third phase now when you now begin to articulate them to
residents. Okay.
And don't forget, the Osomo Power has capacity for 550 megawatts.
Five?
I repeat, 550. Wow. So it'd be like saying they build house now when the 16 flats.
Wow.
You don't finish only 4 flats out of the 16 flats.
You still remain about 12.
When they complete. So what we have finished now is just a small component of the 580 capacity.
My people, when are they here, so? But when are they gathering a question? Because once we get right information, checking, you know, good day. So, thank you very much. You don't explain that one. Our people don't hear. Another thing I want to talk about, a business college of agriculture, Igoraki. I carry Waka go there and say, what did it happen? We're a governor for the same money. I beg, I want to make you see through that on this college of agriculture, Igoraki, and how the government wants to achieve the scope of agriculture to make sure our people go back to fan. So I don't know, make you let our people know.
Okay. That's the part of the strategic thinking when I talk about for this. Governance and leadership is, must be strategic. Not be saying we just do anyhow, anywhere belly face. And so we call and do this one, we play football.
Anywhere belly face.
Oh, your corn, your balloon, the ball, anywhere belly face. Mm. You must be strategic. How do I score the goal? Let me pass it to this person first. Let me go and wait there and wait for the person to pass it to me so I can score the goal. Mm. Now that we call strategic thinking. Now it still lead to that. Once we came to this government, the governor and some of us went to pay a visit to that College of Agriculture. We were ashamed of ourselves. It was like a poultry. The children, when they there, they had become so used to it, to dilapidated existence, that they even thought it was normal.
Wow.
By the time we got out of that place, governor said to him, said to us that even him cannot send in mega
to that place.
To that place. How much more a citizen to that place? Now he talks, say no. We can't. This is not an institution. So he shut it down. It was a dump. It was a shanty. Shut them down.
Wow.
Went to the drawing board. Got eggheads together. Organized. What should the curriculum as a 21st century for an agricultural institution that will support agricultural growth and development? What should it be
in the country?
What should the curriculum be? What should the infrastructure be like? Where should it be located? How big should it be? What resources is required to create such an institution? After all this massive rigorous thinking, all our enemies that time, they go, whoa, Obazaki, you know? But we were thinking, we were working, we were planning, and then, when he press play, boom! Now, there we bow man better pass African man. When African man want to do a 5-year project, they will use only 30 minutes they plan. They use the many 5 years they make mistakes.
Use 30 minutes they plan, use 5 years they make mistake.
Okay, correct. Or break the fair resistance, or bring her down. Or fair this window, or bring her down.
They're not fine rich.
Because they're not planned. But when strategic thinkers like Obaseki won't work, if they get 5-year project, or use 4 years they plan, or use 1 year to execute.
5 years to plan, 1 year to execute.
So that once he press play like this, boom! So that makes you see, say, be like, say, I call it that new color,
Yes.
Because a lot of thinking, a lot of analysis, a lot of evaluation, a lot of rendezvous, a lot of meetings have gone into it, and then resources gathered, and then removed. Now, the same thing happened for College of, what they call State College of Nursing.
Okay.
When governor go there, be like, where did they keep their body? I said, nurses, when one can look after people, they don't know this kind of place, they're going to train them, no equipment, no.
Wow.
As of today, Edo State has perhaps the best nursing institution in Africa.
Yeah.
Perhaps. Yeah. Perhaps the best in Africa. Wow. It is not so big. It is built to accommodate a certain number of students, and every facility required for all those students are there. So if you go and do nursing for America, you go do nursing for England or for Canada, and you do nursing for a Edo State College,
like the same standard.
Like the same standard.
Wait, so I think, repeat that word again. Make
I say, if you go do nursing for Canada, Australia, or United States, or England, or you do in a Edo State College of Nursing, it's the same standard. Not the same mouth. They're there. You don't have to take my words for it. That's what I always say. Like that one politician I talk, you say,
verify.
Go and verify. So the guy at the top, like the guy, he said, go and verify. And they tell you now, go and verify. Go, Sapele Road. Tell them, say, if they not let you enter, go with the place is very structured.
Yeah.
Call me, I'll follow you, I'll give you a letter. They'll let you enter, they'll take you enter the labs, the halls, the classrooms, the hostels, the computer rooms, the conference room.
Wow.
You go tired. The cadavers, everything on there, you go tired. There is no better place to train a nurse in Nigeria than Edo State College of Nursing.
There is no better place in Nigeria than Edo State College
Nursing to train a nurse.
Wow. Any question there before I continue?
No.
Okay, no question. So, my God, we appreciate the way you did the arrangement. Then this Edo job, what is the main aim of Edo job, and how You go fit take carry or to benefit the entire Edo people.
And so that Edo Jobs are just the acronym, now the name, whether they call it that, Skills Development Agency.
Skill Development Agency.
Skill Development Agency. So, because before you begin the work, you must get skills.
Okay.
So, if you say Edo Jobs, want to give people work, which skill they want to use, they do the work. So that means they come design them as a Skills Development Agency. So that you will get that. Agency has the capacity to help you point you in the direction of how you can acquire the skills you need, and then how you can link you to the jobs that that you require those skills yourself. So that NBA, those State Skills Development Agency, they've created thousands of jobs, hundreds of thousands of jobs
now,
in different sectors.
Yeah, no,
different sectors. Number one, if you notice for those states, you see, say, solar. You know, they see every roof.
Everywhere has solar now.
You see solar for. You know, they ask yourself, say, where the people were and they do solar for Lena.
Okay, so now from a good job,
many of them. Many of them. Trainings from those things, they said good jobs. Because they've had different trainings. You see different small makeup studio. You know, they see all the girls now. You see women, all of them fine. All of them fine. No girl were not fine for Nigeria, for Benin again. No, it goes to airport to do everywhere. You see all of them, get their nice shops.
Enter ugly,
you come out beautiful.
Enter ugly, come out beautiful. As a result of Edo Job.
Edo Job. Because a lot of young women have been trained, men too have been trained in arts of, makeups and designs and so on and so forth, doing your hair and all those things. Then, if you notice, most Nigerians, now most Edo people, they only buy imported cloth again.
No.
Most of them, they wear this native and this cotton so locally. Mm-hmm. Not they ask themselves where they learn. Many of them were trained
from that place.
Are you following me? Then, not to talk of, if you go to the Edo State Production Center, you see
for Saplero,
you see what they do, shoemaking, you see what they do. Many of them were trained in by Edo Job. So, the jobs, so if you just say Edo Job, they didn't say, government, you just say, I beg, we want to employ 100,000 people. Skills are generated, people acquire the skills, and then they hook up to enterprises.
Wow.
And so hundreds of thousands
have been judged through that process. Created. So, my people, question already. Okay. So, sir, the bill has said the awareness for no job when they do fly like that. So, which modality do not put in place now to make sure say our people really get more awareness, they really know more about this Edo Job?
The awareness, they don't say no day, my brother. The truth is, they don't say another one bad habit when black person get.
Okay.
Black person only seek information. Unfortunately, one and all of us are the black person. One of our problems is that we don't seek information. We wait for information to come and land in our laps. So you see that adverts are done on TV and radio. You see that adverts are posted on social media, but people will still say they're not here. Why? Because they are not looking out for information. They are not trying to get information that can better their life. In other countries of the world, especially in developed countries, people seek out information.
Information.
You know, when you, if you are, for example, a journalist, you want to be in fora, in different places where the information around journalism a day. You know, so it's not like, obviously, not a day. They're not paying attention. They're not seeking information. Wow. So, I want to use the opportunity to tell the people. So, you need to seek information. Be on social media groups. Listen to radio.
Maybe
some people don't hear. They listen to news.
That's how we get our phone now.
You know, even with the phone, they just use until they play music.
They do TikTok.
They do I was a big musician. And they listen to news, they only read news, they only check what's in the happen.
Well, my people, Bele don't sweep me as the answer me that they explain so many things I don't be happy for here. On that question, I want to ask her because this one will be bothered a lot for since we don't ask questions that concern this modular refinery.
Yes.
And this for the fire, so people say they would exist until some of us come carry our own waka. Go so say, this thing really big. So, one really know the benefit of this modular refinery to the Edo people, how we want to benefit from this modular refinery, or have been a 3D or in a CG, we don't know. I better tell our people.
Well, the modular refinery, as we talk, as I'm talking to you right now, is complete. That project is complete. It's full. If you go there, go fly your drone, you will see.
But I know if you fly drone, if I don't get permission now.
We can link you to the people when they
manage
jump. So that they will
allow you. Link us, we're gonna share.
So you see, it's full, it's complete. The challenge that they are having is accessing crude.
Crude
oil. Because, you know, Nigeria, we have a lot of
politics.
There's a lot of politics. So, and you know, so they've not been able to fine tune the process by which they're going to get crude. Good. Many people, when they set up modular, many of them don't already get mining leases for marginal fields, whatever they do their own, generate their own.
Yeah. But
I'm not sure, say, then get
the
oil well attached to that. That
refinery,
so they have to go to NNPC or all the agencies of federal government responsible for getting crude oil to apply and get supply of crude
to the village
process. I think that's where the challenge is.
That the challenge is that. Hey, good people, now here all of us will need to cry out to make federal government allow crude oil go our refinery. Because if crude oil come there now, gas will, the price of gas will drop. The gas or petrol will drop. So we get more work. So that's the reason why every one of us need to join the government to cry to that bank. When I let crude oil go our refinery. Now we don't know say if they exist. My God, you do well, sir. You still get on that thing where you know say we organic promise during the election. And this matter of gele-gele support. Gele-gele, they don't ask me, I don't know. So if I beg, tell us how far for gele-gele support.
You know the problem when people get about gele-gele? Now, because many times our politicians, they talk about that. Okay. Now, all those politicians, when don't lose out of the power game. You know, say, many of them, now government, they defeat them.
They defeat
them. Many, I don't want to call their name now, but I know many of them. They are former this and former that. You know, anybody when they tell you, say, I'm former special advisor, I'm former commissioner.
They still need their body.
Yes. If I come up for government today, I'm not going to call myself former anything. I'd be professional journalist. I'd be professional PR man, public relations expert. I'd be branding, advertising. I know we'll see, my name is Chris Osagie, former. But some people, now only that former they picked up because they don't get profession. They don't get work. They don't get handwork. They don't get skills. And many of these people, they can't form themselves into association. They call themselves coalition of one thing.
To fight against the
coalition. Meanwhile, now coalition for the lining of the infrastructure. They are all the waiting dependent, we say they are now former. Since they are former, now we say money whatever they hold from government
will not
come again. So let us try and remove the man that is there so that our person can go there and bring us back. That is how can that be the way you live your life? It's very disheartening to find that many of them are even young people. That's how they live their life. So what do they do? They start looking for all kinds of lies to tell. They'll say, oh, Kenwa Road, they never repair it. Oh, this. They'll say, Kenwa Road started 10 years ago when Obaseki never even come on government. And so on. So that's the same line that they talk for the...
This is your gele support.
As I'm talking to you, you want to build support, don't be like saying you want to build 3-bedroom flat.
You want to build support, you know, like you want to build 3-bedroom flat.
Don't be the same thing. They are regulatory... provisions that you must fulfill. There are different things when you must do. You know, and all the processes for the setting of that port are ongoing. There were setbacks at one point or the other. During COVID-19, there was a setback and so on and so forth. But the government has not stopped for one day to pursue. As many of you talk so, by Monday, Benin River Post projects, they are having what we call a public meeting.
Okay.
You know, where they are going to engage stakeholders on the environmental impact when the port will get on the area where they want to set up on Monday.
Today, Tuesday.
About less than 1 week from now.
Wow.
They're having a public meeting to that effect. They are following every step that needs to be followed for the setting up of
a seaport.
Wow. So, Edo people, Mona crossing her finger. Not all projects finish in 1 year or 2 years. There are some projects that have to take some time because of all the regulatory requirements that must be met.
Really
and also all the funds that are required. required to do it.
Well, my people, Ogado answered as one. But then we'll continue to see how we'll fit to put things together by the grace of God. Any question?
Somebody asked, what did they plan for Esan land?
Okay.
Esan land? Esan land, the major part of Edo State. A lot of work is going on in Esan land.
In Esan land, okay.
A lot of roads. You go,
I said, yeah, I will contact this morning.
Boha, be.
Yes, Boha, Ojekba, Obiajo, Boha Road.
A lot of work is going on. Edo State is a big state. So, I mean, a lot of work is going on. I know say one of the major challenges when point is for that side they feel or they face. Now, this Benin Ekpom Aouchi Road,
yes,
when you don't bad. But I would like to apologize to all of them and tell them that we feel their pains.
Mm.
It's very, very disheartening that such a thing is happening. But it's beyond our control as state government. Because that road is a federal government road.
Yes.
And federal government has come out point blank to say that they are no longer going to reimburse any state when they spend their resources
to fix their road,
federal government roads.
Mm.
So, if you consider the resources when they are available to states and how scarce resources, you know, can be in the country right now, you'll see why a state governor would not want to use
his money,
state money, to go and fix a federal road and without any hope of getting that
money back.
Because there are a lot of state roads that also need attention. So we know what they are going through. What we try to do from time to time are to go do
palliatives.
But to bring out 5 billion and do a federal government road and just walk away, I mean,
not possible.
If we don't finish all the states, all the roads when they for inside the state finish, then maybe we can do that. But no, wow. When there are a lot of roads within the state that need attention.
Wow. My people, any other question?
Somebody asked us one
Ewa Bogun has Saple Road to Sapomba Road. It's a link road.
Okay. Yes, there are some roads that have been done that link Saple Road.
Like, yeah, which is
Obaseki is doing his best. And there's a lot of roads that serve that same purpose.
Okay.
I don't think within 8 years we can finish all the
roads. All the road, that's true.
So a lot of work is being done. A lot of roads are being done. Ewa Bogun Road, I go and check whether it's in the list, because we get short list of different roads on the
do. Okay.
Whether it's in the list of recent roads that have to be done. If it is not, our prayer is that we continue to have good governance in the
country. Let's continue.
I will continue to go our way.
Thank you very much, sir. So, thank God for waiting to go on. And at least a 5 o'clock, when you say, ask question. Because the reason a lot of people, they throw stone, they throw missile from anywhere, because they don't get the right information. But thank God, the information that we get them. So thank you very much, and we appreciate you. Then this issue of Edo Best, how does this Edo Best, the reform of Edo Best, affect the people, directly or indirectly?
Edo Best is the reformation of the next generation of Edo people.
The reformation of the next generation of Edo people.
Yes, because you find out today, there is a limit to the amount of improvement you can bring to the lives of human beings that are already mature and are adults.
Yes.
So people have already learned their way. People have learned to be thieves. It's difficult to change them from their way. Sometimes it takes the power of the Holy Spirit to do it. You know, there some people have already learned to be gluttons. They have already learned to be reckless people. You know, people have learned different things.
Mm.
But the thing is, when you want to change the next generation, you go to the child
on the grassroots,
has not been formed fully yet, and you begin to influence that child's life. When you are able to sufficiently and positively influence the life of that child, then you have essentially changed the future of
that child.
Of that child. So that's what Edo Best is. Edo Best is targeting basic education.
Basic education.
Making sure that the average person who goes to school in Edo gets the best quality education at the basic level. They are exposed to, you know, world class technology for teaching.
World class.
Yes, so in those days for our time, they'll say teacher, I want to do a lesson notes.
Yes.
Person when you see the right, knowing right lesson notes is money. Everybody making mistakes.
Oh, making mistakes,
go write one thing we're not supposed to write. Because it's human beings that are doing it. So there is chance for human error. But when you are in the do best, every teacher has a tab
Every teacher every, have that.
Yes, the curriculum when they want to teach, everything when they want to teach.
Even the computer. Videos,
everything pre-programmed to their phones, to their tabs. Wow. And that tab also is enabled with GPS devices that helps us to know that each teacher is at his duty post.
So with that tab, you feel know yes, whether the teacher did the duty post or not.
Yes. So what do you think? What learning outcomes are they trying to improve wow with education? Wow. It's not just that so far they teach. No, so far the teacher is not enough.
So far the
number
teach,
one,
it's not enough.
Number one, the teacher must be there. If the teacher is not there, learning cannot happen. So that's why the GPS is there. To make sure we are able
to monitor them.
That teachers are there. Number two, to be able to learn, you must have the information, the knowledge when you want to pass to the child. And the preloaded lesson.
No. When the child.
When all these factors mix, then learning outcomes goes up. And children learn more.
Thank you. So
that's why the best is.
Thank you very much, sir. I know the teachers from media people say they lack teachers. I don't know how far.
Yes, a lot of work is being done in that area. Recently, there have been this Edu Star program,
okay,
where they are getting some sort of interns, you know, teaching interns, and then they'll work with them for a few months or so, and then make them permanent teachers. So they'll train them, you know, give them the requisite skill and knowledge to be able to dispense the responsibility of teaching, and then they will now send them to different schools. But one of the challenges that we are having all the time is we want to recruit these teachers. We always say people from particular communities should apply for those communities.
Oh, so they can return back to that community.
Yes, and live there and work there. Because when you are living in GRA and you apply to go and be a teacher in Orion,
you don't work.
Hmm. But when you tell all these people, when they apply those kind of applications, they say, look, only on one they go teach. They stay for GRE, you're not going to work. They say, no, I beg, just give me, I need the job, that's all, don't worry. They won't think about, when they don't enter finish, they don't will let us rest.
They're not going to go, they're going to make noise.
Call us, yeah, let's say media, you're very close to the government, help me. I don't like to go on. You say, but when you were being employed, they asked you, they told you that you won't be able to move. So that's why you have these vacuums here and there. So some teachers prefer to be in the city. Most teachers actually.
The question is,
who will teach for village? If all of them did. Okay, at point of employment, they tell you, say, look, now village school, they employ for...
Not before city.
And you say you will fit. Then give you the job finish and you say, you want your school.
Wow. My people, you know why they're happy? Because who not go, no know. When people, they say, Papa said, can you employ teacher? See, he didn't employ. Now, you tell us, okay, if not for Orono, by you go apply, maybe somebody from who won't there make you apply. They don't agree to apply you, but who they believe will apply? Go come say, go Orono, you don't agree to go. Go Orono, you don't agree to go. Now, soon will they do something? Well, as we continue to go on, will they give our updates on those areas by the grace of God? Okay, sir, we don't go to take your time. I don't say they don't call you, but I beg no vessel. This is the issue of Sapne Road. Our people don't need protest. And we remember where our guard governor, he go there, he tell them, when they protest for Ogeki Johnson. He said, okay, man, I don't worry. I only hear when he had the minister of that time. So, una they play politics with the road, now he promised. So, how far? We don't start protesting because may I join the protest.
Look, I don't feel blame anybody when they protest for that road because he can't suffer when people they suffer just to move from beginning to worry. You need to worry when you're sapele, when you're just be quick laughs.
Yes.
It's not too much. So there's only so much a human being can take without responding and reacting. So what you're seeing is that a lot of people are reacting to the pressure that they are feeling. So I quite understand their frustration. But now the same matter when we discuss things about as we talk about Epoma Road.
Yeah.
That road is a federal government road. The government, there's a limit to how much the government can spend on a road. When you not be you, when you not say you not go see the money back. You see how?
Yes.
You know, because if you don't finish all your own roads now, say you have, you have over budgeted, you still have your resources. It will be different matter. But you are grappling with your own roads and trying to make your roads more trivial. The one that is,
when they were using their own.
And the way that they share money for Nigeria, if 10 naira consists, 6 naira stay for federal government. 40 naira share for the many states. So how you constantly go to help the federal government, they do their own, and they don't already tell you who are.
If you join your own.
You're on your own, they don't pay back.
That's where the problem is. I know that people will say, ah, no, you're closer, I don't want. They're the closer I do 5 billion naira project now, 10 billion project. If you closer I do 10 billion project, you go get my nightmares. Wow. It's difficult.
Wow. My people, it affects everybody. But I know saying that because of the system, that's why we'll continue to do what we'll fit do to take help change the negative narrative about governance in Nigeria. And I thank God for the role we Governor Obaseki to play to take ensure say everybody enjoy the dividends of democracy. It's not easy, but we'll get there. Before we continue, any question from our people audience?
Somebody is saying for security.
So make you answer that one.
Yeah, so security, major issue in Nigeria. Major issue in Nigeria. And the way Nigeria is structured so that the people are unable to respond to security challenges.
So that the people are unable to respond
to security challenges. That's how Nigeria is structured, and it's so annoying. You know, if you are in a country where the state governor cannot direct
the police
on what to do, or they don't know what to do. He can't. Meanwhile, he's supposed to be the chief security advisor officer of the state. How does he do the job? Is he going to go by himself into the forest? So that's one of the challenges. Nigeria is defectively structured, you know, and those things have to be changed. The governor who superintends over his state's jurisdiction
should have
the capacity to direct and tell, you know,
the police, the army, DSS, and the
rest. Where to go to, you know, in order to curb insecurity in the country, but it's not so. And then there are several other factors, the socioeconomic factors where they cause until they there, because people are poor and hungry and so on and so forth, and have not been educated, and then it becomes easy for them to be radicalized and turned into killers and so on and so forth. So there's that socioeconomic aspect as well. Yeah, or somebody is hungry, and because he's hungry, then becomes an easy tool in the hand of somebody who wants to cause
more
money or go scatter something. So these are the challenges with security in state. But the state is not resting on its arms. We are doing a lot to ensure that we
tackle those issues.
Hold security in Edo. And I dare say that we are making some headway. We're not there yet. You know, there's still a lot of threats around, but we're making very good strides to improve
security. Jemido, okay, you just see an allusion now. School good old. Education will be scam. Maga, thank you very much. And briefly before we go, make another verse. This issue of Benimo. I don't go there, I don't come out. But our people know the risk concern. See how the traffic, how the place will come be after the door open up. Like sometimes one and all carry and go for a jogbo. Why don't go put out for Luku?
Well, you know, I mean I understand why you ask such a question.
Yes.
Because I mean, you see a big mall,
yeah,
you know, it's located on a very major tributary.
Yes, sir.
Into this in the state, and then you're worried, you know, will you cause congestion or something so forth. So I quite understand. But you see, like I said before, Obaseki does not do things anyhow. If he has a project of 5 years, he uses 4 years to plan.
I use 1 year to execute.
So that's what they call security impact analysis.
Okay.
Traffic impact analysis. Okay. For that, it has been done. They have analyzed it. Wow. They have structured the plan to direct traffic there and ensure that there's no unusual jam there.
Wow.
Of course, without the mall there, there is a traffic jam now.
Yes.
But, so the question is, how do we
control it?
How do we establish this mall in such a way that we don't exacerbate the current traffic crisis that we already have?
Wow.
So that's the thinking that goes into it. And then the governor thinks through everything.
Wow.
The only people went on Sabi Amano, and well, unfortunately, I did see quote unquote, he's not the kind of person that talks too much.
Yeah.
Not the go everywhere, goes down for everybody to talk. Not for these parties, not for that palace, you know, he just keeps to himself. But if you have the rep that I have had to work closely with him, you will learn many things. Mm. You will learn, say, not be giddy, giddy, be work, not calculation, not sitting down to think through.
Be giddy, giddy, work, not calculation. I hear that
one. That's what is unique about our governor. You know, he's,
is always inside his mind. He's thinking, how do we do this? So for the more he thought about it, yeah. So not be when I just suddenly they ask now, easy down. So
plan.
What impact will this project have on traffic? Wow. What impact will it have on the socioeconomic life of the people around
it?
Get my point?
Yeah.
How will it impact the government places here? How you know? And better scientific studies are done.
You don't plan everything.
And scientific solutions are profiled.
I like that one.
So there's not going to be any traffic problems at all because a very extensive security analysis and traffic analysis was done before the project.
Was kicked off. And 2023, generally by the grace of God, that mall will be commissioned. All of us go there. Finally. No, we don't let your guy go now because every people will need to ask a question. I dare you with that. So, sir, this Nigerian Observer, as I read there, I see what it happened. Bless with me. Say, this man, they really plan for the future. But I can also hear some win, some people say, government don't sack them more. Government, why don't sack them more? What did they happen? No, thank God, say, you be here as a media advisor, project to governor, or that back. This reform will really go on for the Nigerian Observer. I want to benefit the masses directly or indirectly. So I beg, make it tell our people.
Well, the truth is that Observer Project, now me directly, the manager.
Wow.
On behalf of the governor.
Now you.
Now me, governor, they use. Now me, the dialogue when governor, they use to write that story.
For that place.
For Observer. So I know everything about that.
Okay.
Yes. Now, media services and media profession don't evolve. Don't change well for us, our society. When we start journalism those days, now facts with the fact story, when we know the when we come up from a head office, we'll fax them. So they wait for facts. So
put out the machine,
they cut them, and do the right good story on top, and put down, the right Adamawa on top, State House story. They can't give the paper to typesetter. We call the typesetter. They don't see Google that time.
Man. No.
When they, if we want to go write analysis, we want to write it. Very well researched analysis. We go library.
But it's we'll really research.
We write. You take small people, jot and you write. You research. But now, uncle, everything don't change. Information age every day. On top of your laptop, you can do any research you want to do. You can analyze anything you want to analyze. So media has changed significantly. So we can observe which was set up. Yeah, almost 70 years ago, 50. So I can't imagine.
Almost,
don't take. He cannot continue to run with old knowledge. So there has to be change. The kinds of printing equipment that are there, the kinds of word processing equipment that are there, the kinds of research equipment that are there, the kinds of information communication technology equipment that are there have to change. And then the ecosystem when one did the around down also has to change. Because media has now gone beyond newspaper.
Before, media has gone beyond
far newspaper. Beyond newspaper. Those days will be over for Lagos when I just start my journalism career. It will be over now. If you want to say anything to the public, must come to us on your television.
Wow.
But now it don't change.
It don't change.
It'll be waiting with the TV talk soon. Not be
Facebook.
Not be broadcast with the broadcast.
The last.
You know, go set up television station.
No.
Now, television station will just
be say so.
So, information dissemination has been democratized, has been liberalized. You know, so we also have to take that into the thinking in setting up that. So, now media city.
Media city.
Wow. So, because some people think in our newspaper around there, there's newspaper there, there's online. Publication there.
Wow.
There is a film production there.
It's
part of communication.
Wow.
It's part of media. There is content. There is production. Skits. All these our boys when they do skits, they do. They're all production. They go on there. There is a media cafe. There where all these buffets sit down. They just drink coffee, drink
Coke and Fanta.
That you are looking at what? The media. See, Obaseki will not be anybody late.
Where to?
Obaseki.
In media city.
How you see for this?
I want to learn journalism.
Obaseki will not be anybody late. Me, when the journalist expert, in teach me. In teach me, say, and they do. And me, sure. What when we don't they do for 20 something years?
Still
teach me some for inside.
Wow. My people, any question there? Okay.
That's the question we did.
Would that be answer?
That's a kind of
law. Aha. So, my people, I did very happy. You know, the reason why negative propaganda they fly, now because say positive propaganda not be fly. So that's the reason why some of us they try to see how we take silence negative propaganda for Edo. Because Edo must be great. Once I want to know, say, a mega agenda, there is nothing like abandoned project under mega agenda. And anything where governor don't start, is the finisher. This one will bring me to the conclusion of the whole matter, which I call the organ matter of them all. Organs are not doing well. We see the role where Una play, where governor play for a card of law, our country can and give federal government, so federal government don't in charge now. But the staff, some of them don't they cry. Some of them will die. Everyone who come here today, say, Apostle, my colleagues don't die. You. So I beg. I don't know the plan when I get for the staff for the form a card of law.
Yeah, well, you know, some people are too stubborn. Yeah. That time when governor will tell them, say, see my plan. We want the federal government to take over this institution. In those days when they grow, they come. People, they happy and say, my institution is a federal institution.
Mm.
The more federal institutions we have in Edo State, the more federal presence we have here. So wow. It's in our best interest as a state to have that additional institution, the federal government, additional federal government institution in Edo State. We have the Aochi, Federal Polytechnic Aochi.
Yeah.
We have the University of Benin, Benin City. We should also have a college of education that is federal. It helps our state. It means the money is coming straight from Abuja,
not from
into America. The state. So governor can say that is it, right? That is the future of that place. Meanwhile, people went there for Ikeado Law, see the new direction, Abudu. We are moving a state college of education now to Abudu and then the other one for Igwebe. You know, so now move your services to those people. Then begin revolt. I can remember during the elections, some of them, not be all though, some of them were genuinely protesting. But many of them go collect money from opposition. They come, they dance for front of government house, thinking, say, all those why you blackmail will make us lose election. But by the grace of God, we still won the election, you know, even though they were trying to embarrass us. Simply why? Because government just said, you know what, this don't be here you day again.
God,
who go down there? Maybe I credit you now. Maybe I put you now for the una role.
They say no.
They say no. They say that they must stay
because they call their placenta for them.
Yeah. So now, so you gonna work for in USC? Maybe you collect salary for John Rose.
You know what?
You know what? So many of the problem when they get was self-inflicted. Yes, they didn't listen. You know, they didn't. And they are, some of them allowed political
leaders to push their
hand. So all those politicians, you know, politicians are very tricky.
Yeah.
Because they say, it's Catalonia, now they're here. They're not going to protest. I say, take, give them money. We're not going to stay government, we're not shut us down. If they shut us down, we just pass on and say, since we're not going to listen to the president, we're not staying one
of them.
So that's how many of them ended up in that situation. I'm sure that there are a few who didn't participate in those things. You know, life with this. But the truth is, the opportunity was created for them to move their services to Abudu.
Wow.
My still on that, there's a concern. Some pensioners from Ikeado Law who claim they have retired even before this whole issue came are complaining that they are still being affected.
Okay. If they are retired, they should have been under the Ministry of Education.
Okay. But
that seems like a unique, new dimension to it. So thank you for that question. I will take that to the Accountant General.
Okay.
And find out what is the provisions for pension for people when don't retire from Ikeado Law long before this became a federal institution.
Okay.
Did the federal government inherit them? Did the state government take them into it? So I'll find that out and we'll come back to it.
Great. Edo must move forward. Indeed, Edo is really moving forward. One more question to that.
The last question.
So okay.
The protest. Mm-hmm. You said there's a protest currently going on.
In this
part of the,
okay.
For
color code.
Color code.
Uh-huh.
Okay. You see, Nigerians, we have to be wise. We have to be smart. We're in exceptional times. So exceptional measures have to be
taken place.
If you now listen recently to government, talking once want to identify
identical for everybody, let them know who did the state.
Not be normal times with this. So in those days, it'd be not hard. Somebody, if you all wake up today, you say, I go with Lorraine, and then I want to go to stay now.
Not get problem.
Not get problem. But today, it's not different. You know? People carry gun, machine gun, enter church for Undo or
finish people.
Some of those people sit down and drink and carry somewhere yesterday night. Some of them maybe chop corn for someone corn station, but they go. If to say who they know who they be, if they more difficult for them to carry
out that attack.
And because they know say nobody know them. So everybody coming to the state, we want to make sure we can identify them. If you say you be bus driver and you are not registered your bus,
we want to know you.
Know you. If you say you be Yaris driver and good,
we want to know you.
We want to know you. Register that Yaris and put a color on it. So you know if you use that thing to Kurukere, we will know where you come from. So it's part of efforts to ensure that we live in a safe society. Wow. That's why we're doing all these things.
Wow. So guys, information is the key. What are the protests? Because of color code. Whether I like them or not, we must identify Una. Una must go right to that name. I must register that motto. We want to fight. Even some of them never be a pet month with it. Una never remove plate number. Mm-hmm. So by the time I commit crime, we know if we catch you now. But Edo is no longer as it used to be. Edo is moving forward. And if you're not ready to take change, follow what it is going. Let me say, you will relocate. So, but once when I know say, Edo must be great. My brothers and sisters in diaspora, when it's going to be make sure they try to get the right information about governance in Edo. Remember, Edo can never be great if there is no peace. That's the reason we'll continue to clamor for peace. No true means I come Edo because you don't like the man who they did there. No true means that. I beg, we need peace so that Edo can become great again. Whether you like it or not, Edo is moving forward. Final word from our God to our people.
My final word to Edo people on this one. Go and verify. Not talk, say, special advisor media. Edo State, don't talk. I believe, not believe.
Go verify.
If you're there for abroad, send your sister, call me the apostle. You know, and say that your sister is sent. All those things when special advisor talk, we want to see them. I go come off of my office, go show you them, or same person follow you. I mean, they tell you that so. So don't just take it. Don't take my words for it. Go and
verify. So God bless you guys. One thing, continue to pray for your governor, pray for the states, and do is moving forward. Thank you very much. My name is my Pastor Alfred of the Oyinosa. The man with the talker and the door and the shroud, as it be. God bless you.